Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel and welcome to Epcot. Today, I want to have a discussion about Disney Vacation Club with you, specifically answer the question whether or not you can use your Disney Vacation Club points at non-Disney Vacation Club properties. This is something we kind of touched on in some of our recent discussions when I did the Welcome Home update, because they did talk about some of your options, and we talked about what you can do if you can't use all of your Disney Vacation Club points in a given year. So today I want to go into a little bit more about this, tell you about some of your options, and share some of my thoughts. Also, we're going to explore the seas with Nemo and friends while we do. But look, here's the thing. I know that this can be kind of a hot topic. People can have a lot of different opinions on this, and that's totally fine. Share yours in the comments. But like I say, whenever we have discussions like this, options like this aren't going to be right for everyone. Some people are going to think that they're a great choice. Some people are going to think that they're a waste. People feel that way about Disney Vacation Club in general. I just want to let you know what your options are, because in the 50 or so years that you might be a Disney Vacation Club member, you might find yourself in a position where you need to know your options. So that's what we're discussing today, and we're going to have a little bit of fun while we do it. Let's start our day with the seas with Nemo and friends. Why not? So some of you who are already Disney Vacation Club members may know, or those of you who have been following along with our DVC discussions, DVC members have an allotment of points that they can use every year. And there are some options. If you can't vacation every year, you can bank points, borrow points. We talked about this in one of our more recent discussions. But what if you don't have the opportunity to go to a location where you can use your Disney Vacation Club points on Disney Vacation Club properties? Maybe you don't have the ability to travel like you hoped you would be able to. Maybe you don't have the opportunity to travel too far. You know, you don't want to do a cruise or an Adventures by Disney thing, a National Geographic thing, all options that are available to you if you have the Disney Vacation Club points available. Maybe you have to go somewhere, you know, something came up with the family or whatever, and you need to travel to a place. You won't be able to use your DVC points at those properties or on those products. Do you have options that are available to you? The answer is yes.
As a Disney Vacation Club member, you have the ability to do something called a points exchange, where you can use your Disney Vacation Club points on non-Disney Vacation Club properties through a company called Interval International.
Now, in the past, it wasn't Interval International. It was a different company called RCI, so if you're a longtime Disney Vacation Club member, you might be more familiar with that.
In the past few years, it did change over from RCI to Interval International, so that's what we're working with now.
Now, even though the company has changed, it still works the same way. Disney Vacation Club members who are eligible to use Interval International. There's some little fine print there, but I'm not going to go into it today. But those who are eligible to use Interval International can, in fact, use their Disney Vacation Club points to book non-Disney Vacation Club properties.
And these could be timeshare properties, or they could be hotels all over the world.
In fact, we have used our Disney Vacation Club points to book hotels in Boston and Tokyo, so we've definitely used DVC for more than just DVC resorts.
Now, people tend to have some really strong feelings about using your Disney Vacation Club points for non-Disney Vacation Club properties.
In fact, people mention it every single time that I talk about this as an option. They'll talk about how inefficient it is, how it's a ripoff. They have a lot to say, but here's the thing. It really depends on the situation. And I know I say that all the time, but it's true. It depends on the situation. It depends on your circumstances and what is going to work best for you and your family on any given year. And you know what? Sometimes it's going to be a complete waste of points. Other times, it's going to be exactly what you needed to accomplish whatever it is that you are trying to accomplish, or maybe even save a little bit of money.
I mean, like I've said, this is something that we've done in one case because we had points that were going to expire, they couldn't be banked, and we weren't going to be able to travel. So the best option was to use them at a location that we were going to be at, because we were going to have to pay for a hotel night anyway. So why pay when you have the points available to you?
Especially when those points are going to expire. That's something that I think is just such an important detail. Oh, look, there's fish in there. I think that that starfish is eating right now. How cool is that? Can you see it? It's like right there, a little piece of fish. But yeah, especially when those points are going to expire, it makes sense. Oh, this one's eating too. It makes sense to use them versus lose them. And I know that there are other options out there as well. There are people who think that the best course of action is to sell those points, rent those points, whatever the case, but that's not going to be right for everyone either. So I just think it's worth mentioning again that this is an option that is available, and it's a pretty good option, at least in my opinion.
Now, let's be clear here for a second. Just because I think that being able to use your Disney Vacation Club points on non-Disney Vacation Club properties is a good option doesn't mean that I think that it's the best option. In fact, it's not an option that I would consider unless I was in a position where those points were going to expire or I really wasn't going to be able to use those points and happened to be traveling somewhere else where I could make them work for me. But generally speaking, if I'm traveling around, if I'm going to a place where I want to find a hotel, even a really nice hotel at the best price, I think that there are other ways to go about doing that without using Disney Vacation Club points through a points exchange. We've talked a little bit about this in the past. There are plenty of websites that you can look at to find great deals for hotels. Recently, I've been using hotels.com. It just is the site that works best for me, which if you've been following along for a long time, you know, hasn't always been the best option. I've been like a hot and cold with hotels.com or with third-party websites. Generally speaking, I've been able to find better deals just contacting the hotels themselves, but recently that hasn't been the case. So anyway, just take that with a grain of salt. But there are other options that can have you staying at great places for great prices without using your DVC points. But again, if you have them and you're gonna lose them, it seems silly to not use them, at least to me. But of course, I'd love to know your thoughts. But again, this also isn't your only option when it comes to using Disney Vacation Club points at non-Disney Vacation Club properties. We've talked a little bit about this before. I think I mentioned it at the start of this conversation even. You can use your points for cruises. You can use your points for Adventures by Disney and National Geographic excursions. At least I think they're called excursions. But again, that's not gonna be right for everyone at every point in time. So, you know, it's just options to be aware of and know are out there, but you also need to be aware of the more basic options too, and point exchanges can be that option. Now look, I want to wrap up this discussion. I know it's just been a quick one, but before I do think it's worth mentioning that some Disney Vacation Club members, I don't know if it's everyone, also have the option with Interval International to book non-point vacations. So there are deals available to Disney Vacation Club members because they have access to Interval International that allow you to book not using your points at properties for a discounted rate. I haven't gone this route yet. I've been taking a look, but it just hasn't worked out for us. But I do think that this is a great option as well. It's another way to utilize Interval International without utilizing your points. And I think it's something that you should take into consideration if you're someone who travels a lot and you're looking for a good deal. I'm sure that we'll end up using this at some point. We just, like I said, haven't gotten around to it yet, but when we do, we'll let you know. Of course, I want to hear from you guys if you've ever used this like feature of Interval International. Let us know in a comment down below. Also, let us know if you've ever used a points exchange. How did it work out for you? What were the circumstances that had you going that route? We want to hear it all. Like I always say, this is a conversation, and giving people an idea of what their options are is the best way to help them decide if DVC and certain options are right for them. So pop them in the comments down below. But I think that's all for now. Thanks so much for hanging out with me. I hope that you had fun in the seas. This was a fun little adventure, wasn't it? But anyway, I'm off to the next. Thanks so much for hanging out with me, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye, guys.